Hey everybody, it's social media producer Tom Barnes of the WGN Morning News. The Chicago scene heading north to Evanston. I'm at the Paws and Claws Chicago Rescue. It's a home rescue started in the pandemic, and it started by a kid in high school, Ashlyn, and her whole family has kind of helped out. We're going to take a look inside because this porch right here is the only spot people have seen for this rescue, because this is where the adoptions happen. They happen outside because of COVID. But I'm gonna get a sneak peek inside, socially distant and safe, right now on the Chicago scene. So let's take a look. And this is Ashlyn. How are you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So you are the creator of Paws and Claws,
yeah,
Chicago Rescue, right?
Yes.
Founder. And we are in the founder's home, right?
Exactly. So this is our home, but it's also a working rescue. So it's kind of been taken over by the animals, which is not a bad thing.
No, not at all. And right away when you walk in, what do we have right here?
So this is kind of our nursing mom and kitten room. Mm-hmm. So this is Mittens right here.
Mittens,
and
huh?
Yes. These are a couple of her kittens. You can see the others kind of just running around.
Yeah. And nursing moms, obviously it's just moms that have just given birth to a litter of kittens, right?
Yes. So Mittens came to us from Southern Illinois, one of our partners in Southern Illinois. And she gave birth to 7 kittens.
Wow.
So and they're kind of all grown now and getting ready to be put up for adoption.
And you were talking earlier about this being a family affair. You're in your house.
Yeah, absolutely.
How did this start? Where did it come from? And how has it affected your family?
Yeah, so we were founded in March. We've really wanted to do this. This has been a dream of ours for a really long time, and we've been involved in kind of the animal rescue world. But in March, we kind of just sat down one night and had a conversation and said, let's start this and let's start saving some lives. That's what we did, and it's kind of really just taken over our lives. And in these past 8 months, we have saved 142 animals. So
142 animals,
yes.
In less than a year.
Yes.
That's pretty incredible, because it seems like you might be outpacing other rescues in general. I mean, what do you think makes you guys that secret sauce that gets you guys that kind of attention?
Yeah, so I think it's really nice because we're really just a family-run rescue. And of course, we have other help, but it's kind of that personal touch. So we really want to get to know our fosters, our adopters, and we really take that time to get to know our animals as well.
And real quick, before we walk in here, I just wanted to show folks, what do you call this little spot right here?
Yeah, so this is kind of our whiteboard, and it just helps us organize our thoughts. So some of these animals here are up for adoption. We have vet appointments over here. And then these are some animals that we're bringing in from Louisiana.
So you're working with other rescues and organizations?
Yeah. Yes, we are. So all over Illinois, Louisiana, Indiana. And then we of course help Chicago a lot as well.
And this is kind of a one-stop shop in terms of people who want to adopt, because you guys do vaccinate the first set. What were you calling them earlier?
Right. So yeah. So we do core vaccines here.
Core vaccines. Yeah.
We're lucky to be able to do them here, and it helps, you know, lower costs, but also it helps with, you know, our kittens' stress level, so they don't have to go to the vet every time. And then of course they're spayed and neutered, and they're up to date on everything they need to get medical wise.
And you guys work with a network about about 50 families, you said,
yeah,
that are,
yep,
the foster families, right?
Yes, yeah, we do. So we have some really wonderful foster families who do kind of all different sorts of things. But essentially, they just welcome animals into their home, and they care for them, and we provide medical support and all the supplies they need. And they make this possible, so we're so grateful for them.
And all that happens outside on the porch just because of the pandemic, right? So people come out, or they're in their cars even.
Correct.
Hang out in the car, get used to the animals. And it's not just cats, even though right now it's a lot of cats and one sole pup.
Yes,
but it's just because that's just kind of how it happened for you guys, right?
Correct, yeah. So we do dogs, but it's just really the need for us has seemed to be cats. So we do a lot of kittens, a lot of adult cats, medical cases. It's all over the board, but we do dogs. It just, you know, it happens.
Who do we have here?
So this is No Way.
No Way.
Yes.
Well, how did No Way get the name No Way?
So her name, she has 4 siblings, and all of their names originate from different languages, and they mean beautiful.
Oh.
So there's No Way, there's Mio, Tegan, and 2 others, and they all mean beautiful. So She came to us from Iowa, and she does have some medical needs. She has an oral hematoma, but she is on the way, on her way to being all healed, and she's going home this week.
You say that like you've been a doctor or a vet for 10 years. I mean, I don't even know how to say that, and I just heard it, and you said it like you've known it. I mean, is this, I'm guessing you want to be a vet of some kind or in the animal field in some kind at some point?
So I'm interested in shelter medicine. Mm-hmm. I've really been forced to understand and start to really get to know all of these medical terms and the different needs. It's been a lot, but it's been really wonderful.
And it's a total family affair because we got mom over here and your sister, and all you guys kind of play a part. Like your sister, explain real quick what she does. And what's her name? I'm sorry, I didn't.
Yeah, this is Kelsey.
Hi, Kelsey.
This is one of the kittens she raised. So this kitten came to us when he was very, very small. And unfortunately, his mom passed away. She died outside, and he was left an orphan with two other siblings. So what Kelsey has done is she has raised him as a bottle baby, which means that she has been feeding him from a bottle every 2 hours.
Every 2 hours?
Correct.
Even at night?
The night. Yes, exactly.
You get up in the middle of the night to feed cats? Yeah?
Yeah.
That's dedication right there. Exactly. And maybe a little pressure from big sister, right?
Well, I mean, she's wonderful.
Yeah. So. And you also have a brother that helps out, too, with the website, right?
So my younger brother has done all of the website stuff, and he's just 11 years old, but if you go visit our website, you'll see how great of a job he's done.
And speaking of the website, why don't you give that out real quick?
So our website is www.pawsandclawschicagorescue.org.
And that's where people can find out information on how to adopt or even donate, because you guys are based... survive on donations, right?
Correct. So we've been very lucky to have a lot of support, and we're so grateful for our donors, but we're always kind of in need of support, donations, fosters, and of course adopters. So a lot of the animals you've seen today are actually up for adoption and looking for their forever home. Yeah. So this is Ann and Moose. They're a pair. They came in solo, so they did not come in together, but we paired them together, and obviously they've become very fast friends.
And that's kind of how you adopt out, right, in pairs?
Correct. So we always adopt out in pairs, and it's very rare that you'll see a kitten on our website who is looking for a home. It's just so much better. They're so much happier, and of course they have a lifelong friend too.
And you also said that there are certain times of year where maybe you'll have more cats than dogs because there is something called the kitten season.
Yeah,
why don't you explain it real quick?
Yeah, so kitten season, females just tend to reproduce more when the days are longer. So of course we kind of have a little bit of a quieter period. We still have kittens, of course, but during those cold, kind of cloudy, short winter months.
Real quick again, the social media handles for the rescue.
So both our Facebook and our Instagram are Paws and Claws Chicago Rescue. So you can see, I mean, it's wonderful to see the animals and kind of stay up to date on what we're doing here.
And people can donate monetarily wise, or they can donate, you said you got one of these little houses just dropped off the other day, or supplies, anything, right?
Yes, so we're always in need of supplies, especially kitten wet food. So that's kind of our biggest wish list need all the time. And you can find that on our Chewy and Amazon wish list on our website.
Ah, perfect. Well, thank you, Ashlyn, for inviting me into your home. I appreciate it. And everybody here appreciates what you and your family are doing. So very nice to meet you. All right, there you have it. That's the Chicago scene here in Evanston for today. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. That's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Until then, I'll see you later. Bye.